les miro mientras me rasco la barba como James Harden. La sangre, las ganas, la fama, la tensión, el hambre, la visión de Ricky, el poder de DeAndre. Así es de Tracarde, mételo en tu playlist luego. No soy Anthony Davis, pero si llego retumba el suelo. Altos vuelos cada noche como Donovan Mitchell. Entrenando y entrenando, no hay más pitcher. Da igual quien me fiche, los coaches me van a admirar. Después de jugar me echaré un free de rap con Lilar. Soy el pilar de mi equipo como la tipo, me juego el tipo desde
chico. Welcome everyone to the Sports Gambling Podcast and D-Gen Madness presented by mybookie.ag, where we're giving away $3,000 courtesy of Barking Dog Partners in our bracket challenge. Still time to get your bracket in. Go to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/contest, sportsgamblingpodcast.com. Sit next to me, my partner in picks, Ryan Real Money Kramer. What's happening, Kramer Dog?
I'm at least three quarters ready for this, if you know what I mean. A lot of self-quarantining. The world is ready for the healing to begin, Sean.
The healing is about to begin because, of course.
While we talk through it, we should real quick. I'm going to explain. You're seeing the lineups.
Yes.
It's going to take a little time to get past this, so I'm putting out. This is just to be on record of who's playing who. We're now going to advance to the game while Sean brings on our established, esteemed. What do they call him? The color guy.
Colby Dant, aka the Dant Base, joining us here as we watch this simulated NCAA tournament, D-Gen Madness. 30 teams loaded up here. We're running it on NBA 2K20. So if you're wondering, there's some comic, there's some pretty funny crossover of people accidentally making it into the game that are NBA. But we're doing 5-minute quarters. Of course, the spread -3.5 for Michigan. Total sitting at 84.5. I'm on Michigan +3.5. Colby, what are you doing here?
I'm on Butler, and I could when I arrived here, I could feel that there was a chill in the room, nervous energy. Kamara Baldwin said he would be playing without his mask today, so I really commend the Butler team for playing without the mask.
They are doing it.
And here they come. We're about to see the tip off to D-Gen Madness. It's going to be an exciting tournament, and I can't wait. Again, this is where we're at. We're watching.
Did I just see some Trump signs?
I have been watching a lot of these, and there are advertisements that have no affiliation with the sports gambling podcast, including big companies. I think you see some Amazon in there.
Okay.
But I did notice there are hilariously
NBA going after their demographic. Huh?
I have also been informed by the powers to be, who may or may not be taking action on these games, that I must show these sliders. So I'm going to start from the bottom. This is all default Hall of Fame settings.
Just showing everything's above board here in hashtag.
These are default.
We're not rigging anything here. We run a clean product here.
I will call out not a default right here. I added 5 to the attack the basket.
Oh, wow. Okay. That should help the over betters.
I added 10 to take 3-point shots. This is college basketball. I wanted to induce some more shooting.
I don't like that.
They're all playing defense by the same rules. Decreased the fatigue rate by 5 because it was ridiculous. These guys were getting tired. 5-minute quarters. They're obviously not staying in shape in the off season.
It's the virus, man.
And I think that's about it. I'm going to scroll up, show you the rest. This is again documentation.
Lay these up are defense all, strength. I like
these
that.
Are Hall of Fame defaults again. All of these,
if Colby had his way, the
last one travel
being called would be jacked up to 100.
3-point success,
four corners offense in effect.
3-point success. I bumped up 10 to 65 again. College basketball, the kids were rated appropriately for being college players, but the 3-point line is a little further. Wanted to account for that. This is the sliders. Now I think it's time to go. What you didn't ask me who I'm taking.
Kramer, what are you doing? I know I'm on Michigan -3.5 under 84.5.
You wearing Harbaugh khakis over there?
And for those, I just had to change this camera setting because some of these state custom built stadiums, I feel like they didn't complete all the way, much like the LA Rams stadium. And there's some flaws in the camera.
If you saw the opening player ratings, Xavier Simpson, very high at an 80. The rest of the Michigan squad, I think, rated pretty high. I'm going to take them and the points. And again, when you're handicapping new leagues, I like to take the points and the under.
You know, with the Trump sign there, you guys, I was at Hinkle Fieldhouse just a few months ago. And I, you know, I feel like they're really on par with everything here. I met some guys in Indianapolis, some Trump supporters, my Uber driver was a
I'm
Trump
going
supporter.
All in on Trump.
So I'm excited about this. They really nailed it.
They nailed the demographic. All right. Thank you guys as always for tuning in. Hopefully you got your brackets ready. Hopefully you got your bets in over at mybookie.ag.
Are we good, Sean? Before we get started with the game,
yeah, we're good. I don't think we're not live on Twitter, but other than that,
we're not good. Live on Twitter.
No, I don't see it. Unfortunately, that feed looks like it's crapped out, Kramer.
We'll see if we can sort that out. Should we sort that out before we start the game?
All right, yeah, give it 2 seconds, Colby. Anything you're looking at in this matchup as you break it down?
Well, obviously Juwan Howard's got no coaching experience in any form of a tournament, with the exception of even the NBA playoffs. He was on the Miami Heat bench deep when they went on their run. But as an actual player, and when he was on the Bullets, he never went anywhere. So he's got to be feeling the nerves. It's not since 1993-94 when he was a part of the Fab Five. So
Colby, you know, we got some chat going on in the YouTube chat room. Rocky Parrish, Colby, what side are you on so I can bet the opposite? We already got guys fading our college basketball expert, Colby Dant, aka the Dantabase. And if you're tuning in for the first time, you're seeing the Twitch feed over at mybookie.ag. You're listening, of course, to the Sports Gambling Podcast. Subscribe today, sportsgamblingpodcast.com. Available where all great podcasts are sold. Or in this case, download for free, because we're just a free content train. Kramer, let's do it. Let's get this game.
Well, I think in trying to repair the Twitter issue, I think all the feeds may have restarted. So I'm going to give it a second if you're watching to make sure it's still there.
Okay. I'm still seeing that we're live on YouTube, Ryan.
Great. Great news. Let's confirm we are back up on. We are live on Twitter.
Okay.
All right.
There we go. We got a live feeds set up. Hopefully you guys got your bets in. They even have some interesting bets, odd or even total. I'm going even there. Give me even all day. Something to sweat out for the entire game.
I'm going odd, Sean.
Colby, what are you doing? Odd or even?
I'm with even on this one.
And there are even future bets. So still time possibly to squeeze in a future bet over at mybookie.ag.
Oh, and the coaches, look at that realism right in the, right on the junk immediately, like a close up.
They're doing some nice dabs there. Home court advantage for Butler D+.
Bullshit.
I disagree. I've been to this place. This place can rock. You
Butler
know?
Has the opening tip, taking it down Thompson. The court.
There we go. You know, set up some offense here. Get some motion going with this Bulldog team here. Going to ISO to the big man. Oh, jeez.
And that's what I'd like to see out of Michigan. Signals a jump ball here. Well, that of course is one difference. There are jump balls in D-Gen Madness because we're simulating this on NBA 2K20. So hopefully none of your handicapping relied on the fact that jump balls.
The backcourt, though. Backcourt.
Wow.
Beautiful.
I will say this as the preparer of this content. I watched a lot of these games. Not one backcourt. The nerves are getting to them.
The tournament starts. You know, Juwan Howard. Like I said, he hasn't been here before. There's Baldwin. There we go.
Great take to the basket. Butler out to a 2-0 lead. Michigan, of course, still covering +3.5. And don't be afraid to check out mybookie.ag. During the game, because there are live lines, we got a turnover. But they also have the very
best of care. All right, run the offense here. Run the offense.
Now, here's
come on. Too much dribbling. Too much dribbling. See some high screen roll action. No, I thought it was gonna be.
I'm a
fade away. Baldwin. No. Hung on the rim, but
wouldn't fall for him. Couldn't get that in. This is where. Oh, nice move to the basket. Oh, you got to
finish.
You got to finish that.
Easy 2 points just never materialized.
And Michigan's length is coming to play early. Great defense and the defensive board.
This has been going pretty fast. Pretty fast so far. There we go. That's a bad shot. Bad shot. Good board.
We're not giving the fans what they want to see, and that's high scoring and good looks.
And you know, guys, I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested.
There we go.
That was a contested bucket. Butler out to a 4-0 lead. Michigan needs to settle down, work their offense.
Yeah, someone pointing out that this is in Indiana, so perhaps that's why the Trump billboards are up. A long time without a
bucket. Yeah, they have not scored in this game. Again, great look for people,
man. You know,
if you're sitting on an under 84 and a half, you got to be feeling good even this early.
Good.
That's a great take.
One for one with that shot.
If you allow him to get that close, you deserve to get scored on.
Was that Eli Thompson Brooks, Colby?
I believe so. Here we go. Nice. Look at this offense running. Where's the foul, too? Come on. Once he got to the 10,
I think he was surprised. So Colby Dan is a fan of fouls as well. For those who have never heard Colby.
Kamar Baldwin is really the player of the game right now as Butler's up 6-2.
He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Has to clutch.
Got to get the big man inside. Oh, great cut to the rim. Contested jumper.
Steven B on Periscope pointing out my first half unders looking good. Watch out, though. Scoring can happen fast.
Brooks covering.
Baldwin is doing a lot of isolation.
Baldwin is a tough guard right now.
Oh, he's open, though.
Send over to Bryce Golden. What's going on here? Let's get some movement going.
Here's Baldwin. Brooks covering.
Jesus. Oh my God! Are you kidding me?
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
Let's go, Butler.
That is a 30-footer from way behind the arc for Butler. So far today. And you need to call a timeout.
Juwan Howard's got to think about this. And guys, they he needs to go to his assistant, Phil Martelli, former St. Joe's coach. He's been in this situation several times.
Certainly not a Fab Four for Michigan. Has only 4 points so far in this first quarter. And here come the guys with the t-shirt guns giving the crowd what
all
they
right,
want to
so
see.
So we're a minute 30 into the game, Sean.
You're a minute 30 left in the
30
first quarter.
Left in the first quarter. Does anyone have the live odds over up at my bookie? Anyone looking at those live odds?
I'll pull that up, Ryan, as we do. Right now I'm seeing Michigan getting 6.5 points.
Wow. Whoa.
And I love that. I mean, we've seen Michigan when they set their offense, they get it going. There is a potential there. Now, Butler, first off, that 3-pointer was a prayer. That was an outlier. I'm still on the under and Michigan 2K CPU plus 6.5. Great value there.
If you know Kamar Baldwin's game, he can make those crazy shots. I expect a lot more of it. Maybe not from that far out,
yeah,
but I would expect.
And that's where Kramer and the adjusting of the 3-point rating has definitely paid off.
And at this point, before we get back to action, we don't care about these fake records. Special shout out to all the people coming to us, because we're also broadcasting, Sean, live to the My Bookie NBA 2K Twitch feed, I believe.
Nice. Awesome. Cross promoting.
One of the Twitch feeds
again,
over there.
Big shout out to My Bookie for being the presenting sponsor of the podcast. Oh, great look.
Wow.
Did not go in for Michigan. And now Butler.
Oh, to Baldwin. Oh, beautiful basketball, Sean.
Butler jumped out to an 11-4 lead. And if Michigan wants to be in this game, they have to do something about Kamar Baldwin right now. He is picking them apart. Great.
Wide open three. There we go. Needed that one.
That's settled it. Settle the team down. Michigan now only down 4.
Look at this movement, though. As a fan of offense, you gotta love this. I see that's a good look, though. I can live with that all day.
Open look for the 3-pointer there for Butler. Nunez to the hole. Great use of the glass. Didn't go in. From what?
He's got him open. I'm giving up, man. There's Baldwin even rebounding now. Give him a foul. Come on.
How did Baldwin get behind anyone there? He's just posting up in the restricted area.
Right now, what I'm seeing is I'm seeing a Michigan team that just needs to relax. This is why we take the first half unders.
Now
they're only down 4.
This pace has really picked up. Ooh, good look. Wide open 3 for Michigan.
2 seconds. 1 second from long range.
Oh.
We're going to get one of those to go in. That ends the first quarter. Butler up 11-7. If you had the under right now, you're on pace for 72 total points, well under the posted 84.5 at mybookie.ag. Let's head over. Well, we're going to get a little update here from the cheerleaders while we do some updating. Live line, of course, now down to 5.5 for Michigan, -5.5 for Butler. Odd even points still out there, still available. So again, I don't know how you possibly see that coming, but yeah, we got some t-shirts going. The action's back. Kramer, what do you think of the game so far?
You know, I'm working, Sean, and you know, us professionals, we're not supposed to be biased, but I like what I'm seeing from Butler. I'm a little worried that they Michigan settled it. As we see, they settled the burst, and now we have a matchup.
Now a deep three again for Michigan to cut it to 11-10. Colin Castleton from downtown Butler looking to answer.
Ace Blazer 12 on Twitch pointing out at least the commentators are entertaining.
There
Thank
you go
you for that. Still no points in the game and out of bounds. Wow. Wolverines wow. Possession. Butler needs to refocus. They're at home.
Basketball is a game of runs.
Shout out to Nick Francis on YouTube saying he wished we worked real games. Oh, if only. Now imagine watching a broadcast where the broadcasters are also gambling on the game. For the integrity of the game, I didn't place my bet on my bookie. I placed it through Ryan Kramer. We booked some local action here.
Yeah.
I'm on Michigan +3.5. I feel good. I feel good where we're at. We just got to.
Oh, no, see, that's good offense right there.
That's how you run the Michigan offense. Use your size of your advantage. Get in the paint. Don't settle for contested jumpers.
Wow, I just took a chug of this whiskey as if it was water. I'm feeling good.
We
need cuts. Butler team is not cutting.
They're relying on Kamar Baldwin and his isolation.
Wow, what kind of defense is that?
There we go.
Wow, that was a great.
Is that Jordan Tucker?
That was Henry Badley, and what a bad mama. There goes that bad man with the finger roll to the rim, uncontested. Summer basketball camp at Miami. Wow.
What I want to know is how many people have this streaming on their TV? How many people are watching this on a TV like it's a real game?
And if you have a smart TV, perfect. Just use that YouTube app, pull up youtube.com/sportsgamblingpodcast, and there's a million ways you can watch us.
Now, guys, we're 7-8 minutes into this game, and there has not been one whistle blown yet.
No, and it's been, with the exception of the backcourt violation that started the game off.
It was one of the refreshing things about virtual March Madness is it's not a bunch of officials trying to make a name. It's not a bunch of officials.
There we go.
Takes it to the rack.
Right there. Okay.
It's not a bunch of officials trying to make a name and being the next big star on Dancing with the Stars, shimmying down the field to call that charge.
I as much as it annoys me, I do like when they wind up to make the charge call.
No, you don't.
It's fun. Right now, update on the score. Butler 13, Michigan 12.
Khalif Baldwin shooting 2.
Under still looking good. Khalif Baldwin, a little bug-eyed in the in the animation. That's an unfortunate choice there. But if they can get these buckets here, maybe extend it to a 3-point lead. If you're Butler, that's what you got to hope. You got to hope they figure out how to get Kamar Baldwin going, not just being in isolation.
But at the same time, if they can get Khalif Battle going, if they can get some of the other guys going, I feel like Butler can really run away with this thing. They're at home.
And Badley. But I love that that finger roll that Badley had to the rim, in spite of the fact that I have Michigan +3.5. I think the game plan for Michigan is pretty simple. Keep using your size, keep pounding the paint, and out physical this Butler team. Big Ten basketball at its finest.
And I really appreciate Ace Blade, Scotch Notch, because I think he just paid me the highest compliment that one can be paid when you enjoy a little of the cannabis, and that's being referred to as Bill Walton. So thank you, sir. We will have the Ducks, I think, tomorrow. When do we have the Ducks?
From the League of Champions.
Quack, quack, quack. We'll have to rock tie-dye shirts. Big Dog.
That's a good look, though. I can live with that look all day.
That's a fun aspect of the game, the nicknames program did.
Big Dog is a shout-out to Glenn Big Dog Robinson of Purdue.
And to think, I thought they were the Blazing Blue.
Yeah, you got to do a reference to like the Rolling Stones or the Beatles or Bob Dylan or something if you're going to be Bill Walton.
We have a touch of gray here in this matchup as the over is not look. It is not a China Cat sunflower for over betters.
There we go. Oh, jeez. Good God.
The things that get me pumped watching this game are the same things that get me pumped watching NCAAs. Just insane blocks, deep threes. Michigan, of course, has cut it to a 1-point point game.
Real quick, Sean, while we have a break, I'm going to reply to Stephen B on Periscope because he pointed out how he likes the children on the bench. So what you'll really enjoy is to fill out the requirement of the NBA roster. There's a bunch of generic, like 5'8" people that look like. I wanted to make sure they looked like Sean Green.
Thank you. And I'm 5'9½". And much like Simpson, I can hit a wide open mid range jumper like he just did.
Xavier Simpson, not normally known for his shooting ability, but hey, you know what? He's a senior. This is the tournament. D-gens only.
And Michigan, first lead of the game, 16-15.
There we go. Well, you get too no fancy
call,
with
no call
it.
There.
Getting too
great
fancy.
Great defenses. Well, Michigan collapsed the lane.
Ooh.
Of their bench, and they provided a yeah, look at that.
Michigan 26.
shooting
bench points.
75%. Is that the bench shooting?
That's got to be from another game.
We got to calm down. We need to get Baldwin involved in the offense right now. He's not touching the ball.
Here, he's got it now.
There we go. That's good. And a, come on. They got him with the body.
And that's an example of this is my favorite part so far is Colby just clamoring for fouls.
And that's actually Aaron Thompson. I think we had been calling him Baldwin by accident.
Baldwin's three.
Yeah. Boomer from downtown. Much like primetime's ESPN. Back, and it's gone.
And about 2 minutes into this game, you probably thought you were locked in on that under if you had the under. Not so fast.
The over creeping back into play as Michigan's up 19-17, 36 total points so far.
See, Butler's got to get better defending the three right now because Michigan's starting to get hot from behind the arc. So,
and now
they got to
tie game, last possession most likely 19-19.
Oh wow! Just let him slice through the defense.
He passed up the open layup for a deep two. And the call will go against Boomer. And an offensive foul.
What?
That's a bad foul right there.
So realistic. So realistic.
It was also very weird that he raised his hand. It's like, dude, you only do that if there's a star player around you that you don't want to get the foul call. But that's a class act that you expect from Michigan. Go, Big Blue.
Is Baldwin?
Oh,
come on.
Deep three did not go in. Exciting first half. Michigan Butler tied at 19.
Sean, we got to ask the fans. Let me just dial down this audio a little bit. We got to ask the fans, who do you have in your pocket for futures in D-Gen Madness? Real quick, Sean, before we answer that ourselves, H-Town 51974 on Twitch asks, why 5 minute quarters? Well, here at the Sports Gambling Podcast, we like to create digestible content.
Yeah.
I think, you know, 40 to 45 minutes for the game is what we were going for. So that's why.
Ryan, breaking news.
Someone's pointing out that 40 minutes is actually 10 times four. Thank you. Yeah, we cut it in half on purpose. We highlighted this. Anyway, Sean, let's talk about the game.
Breaking news, Michigan +3.5. We've reset back to the game line as it's tied 19-19. So that's 38 total points. Still optimistic for my under 84.5. And stay tuned for the late game 7 o'clock projected tip. North Carolina CPU squaring off against Gonzaga CPU. 10.5 point spread right now for UNC. Total sitting at 87.5.
Rematch of the national championship just a few seasons ago. I'm really looking forward to that one. Somehow North Carolina finds himself in this tournament.
We have Rocky Parrish checking in. He likes Oregon +2300.
I'm just going to pause it for a second to give anyone an opportunity to get down on that halftime. And while we talk about that, Sean, did you just say 2300 for who?
Oregon.
I like that. Peyton Pritchard.
Quack. Look, I like Maryland. I believe it was +1700. I think Maryland, I've been saying all year, they're the most talented team in the country, but I worried about Mark Turgeon coaching. Well, guess what? In the D-Gen Madness, I don't know that coaching's a huge, you know, there's a huge curve on coaching. So I'm going to go with Maryland and the talent.
All right. I mean, I'm candidly, have we quickly discussed the nightcap?
Yeah. Yeah. We threw that out. I'm also going to be on. I'm just going to lean dogs as well in the late game. Give me UNC +10.5. Kramer, I know if you listen to the podcast, we gave out all our week one weekend picks. And of course, tune in at Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, two games a night, 9 PM East, 6 PM on the West Coast, doing eight games, double headers, back to back to back, giving you that quarantine content you crave.
Risking hashtag, the virus. We're out there hashtag, risking the virus for you guys.
Hashtag Degens only.
Risking
hashtag
it.
Hashtag Degens only.
Risking it for the biscuit.
And Kramer, you're on Gonzaga minus 10.5.
I am. And I think it's time. Are we ready?
Let's get back. Let's get back to the action. Everyone's got their second half in. And let's
here we go.
Baldwin's got 7 points. He probably had 7 points in the first minute of this game, I feel like. So they got to get him back involved with the offense if they want to win this game.
And then it's Little General, and it's Thompson. And it's
Little General, baby.
Is that Xavier Simpson? Oh, there's Baldwin making some plays defensively. Even three on three break. Oh, give it back up, man.
Horrible.
Offensive board, though.
Really settling there.
That's a foul.
No, that is a clean steal for Michigan. Taking it back the other way.
You know, Sean, I don't even care about my bet. I just want to have a great game for the fans.
Oh, geez.
We're bringing it back together.
I want to have a great game, and I also want to cash Michigan plus 3.5.
Don't take the competitiveness out of this.
I'm fine with that shot. You get in the paint. You get a good look like this.
But why? Okay.
Interesting choice by Baldwin to settle for the jumper there.
He knows his game.
Instead of going for the layup, I would have went in there. The vape pen is active in the DGens only studio if people are wondering at home.
Yep.
We also got
kind of defense?
I thought that was a little bit of a moving
great,
screen.
And that's
if you
how
ask
you
me.
Take it to the hole. Game tied 21-21. This is what the fans want to see. Completely
off guard. Yeah, if that's a harbinger. Sean, you're doing a great job so far.
Thank you, Ryan. Having a very big second half. Appreciate this is a team game, and shout out to Ryan for making sure all the
and much like many progressive organizations out there, we here at the Sports Gambling Podcast and the Sports Gambling Podcast Network felt it important that we have a co-ed refereeing staff for DGen Madness. So timeouts.
Now all the listeners are making jokes about her blowing the game, Ryan. What did you do? We're trying to run a clean, top-notch organization providing opportunity and certainly tons of betting opportunity at mybookie.ag. If you're just seeing this live, just tuning in, you can bet on this video game that we're watching. It's being simulated. Michigan still getting that plus 3.5 on the live line. Get in, get involved.
Nick Francis telling both of us, Sean, that we are risking it by hanging out with Colby's bartending ass. Colby's actually been in quarantine longer than us.
I've been unemployed for a while now.
Magician comes in for
Now, one thing I will say is the Michigan bigs far more athletic than the Butler bigs. Oh, see, that's another reckless shot.
Don't need to do that, Michigan. You've been getting good shots. Butler up to a 22-21 lead. And that could have been a game changer. That could have been some momentum and one for Butler. I'm fine with Michigan sending him to the line. If you get that much of a contested look, I'm totally fine.
I love the way Butler has, they've changed their offensive agenda. The second half, they're attacking the bigs, getting the bigs in foul trouble. Cause that's the key to them winning this game.
Are you on Butler?
I am.
Shout out to super fan friend of the program, Alan Cooley, tweeting out a photo of him streaming the game on the 65-inch.
Yes.
We were planning on being out in Vegas for March Madness, hanging out with guys like Alan Cooley, dropping a couple cold ones and doing some betting. Wasn't able to make that happen, but this feels like the next best thing, watching this game. Drinking some beers, drinking some whiskey.
I miss my
pen.
I miss my cab driver.
The cab driver was hysterical.
Best part about this tournament, much like March Madness as well, we scheduled it such that we will push back every game that happens
if needed.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well played. Well played.
Butler 24-21.
Fell asleep behind the wheel.
The big dog is barking, baby. Well, you know it's gonna fire up, Greg. Everybody on that big dog is barking. Great cut to the hole by Michigan there. 24-23 is the score. Butler up by one. But that felt like that dunk was a momentum building dunk.
Shoot! Shot clock running out.
Contested three. Great board.
Got to get some more
again by the big dog.
Ace Blazer 12 checking in. Just put a nice, a cool 250 on under 87 the Zags game.
Nice.
Good luck to you. I agree. That number feels a bit high.
What a move. Spin move three.
Wow.
Colin Castleton is, if Michigan pulls this out, he's making a run for player of the game. Michigan up 26-24. MyBookie.ag, considering offer player of the game props later on in the tournament.
Nice answer.
And Butler answers. Great look from behind the arc there by Sean McDermott.
McDermott
also Bill's head coach, apparently. So doing double duty, trade for Stephon Diggs and draining threes. All here's Boomer.
And it's now, if McDermott gets hot,
sorry, I miscalled him a big dog. Boomer. And again, Boomer, aka Castleton, making a run, player of the game, 28 for Michigan, Butler 27.
Sean, it's opening night, DJ Madness. We have a minute 40 left in the third quarter. It's 28-27. We've had 9 lead changes. Are you kidding me?
This is a back and forth
no
affair.
No one remembers the backcourt violation two seconds into the game.
It started with a jump ball to a backcourt violation. My stomach tightened because I go, oh my God, this is going to be boring. It's not going to be exciting. And I was completely wrong. This is completely exciting, completely thrilling. I'm sitting on my +3.5 ticket. I feel very good, but things could get weird late. Shout out again to my bookie.ag, setting a very sharp line at +3.5. The total did seem to be a bit high, but we're things could get crazy here late.
One thing to watch: if Michigan does get a big lead in the fourth, Xavier Simpson, a terrible free throw shooter, that's their Michigan's point guard. That's who they trust with the ball. We'll see how this goes down the stretch, but I would imagine that they're going to find ways to not get him the ball if that's the case.
And shout out to sophomore Colin Castleton, the 6'11 forward from Dayton Beach, Florida, is shooting the lights out for a big man.
If Butler can get McDermott going, the guy is a good jump shooter and just a dangerous threat.
Butler just seems hot and cold, right?
They took Baldwin out of the game. Normally you follow it when Baldwin's out of the game, they really struggle to score, Sean.
Yeah, and you're what looking right this? Now, not getting anything good going with the offense.
Shot clock
right now for three.
Ooh, that's
you
a good
look. You
don't
want your big shooting threes,
That's fine, though. Yeah. That's fine.
Castleton again. Oh, looked like he had a good that was a good take by Boomer, and I'm fine with him taking that shot. A
lot of Boomers on the court.
Of course, people are joking that since COVID-19 is attacking older people, it is the Boomer remover. That's what the Smith, young people are saying.
You know, that's Rick Smith's son
it
in
is.
The game.
Great
Derek Smith.
Oh. Boomer for three. Onion
shot. Get out on that, man.
His momentum, his shooting is carrying this Michigan team right now to a 31-27 lead over Butler.
How realistic are those buckets when they rattle in? I love, that's my favorite.
It's a great animation. And I'm glad we did this on NBA 2K20. I saw some people trying to do it on NCAA 2K9.
Oh,
it just looks so old. And Ryan, much like we're at an actual sports book clapping, it reminds us me of the time when we went to Washington State University to hang out with Mike Leach, and we got yelled for applauding Wazoo in the press box, which you're not supposed to do.
Even though
we all had Wazoo laying, 12.5?
We're wearing Wazoo gear.
Walked away to make my coleslaw sandwich, and I heard you guys get scolded for cheering.
We're not professionals, but we know how to pick games. Deep shot.
Ooh.
I think that
was in and out.
Yeah.
I think they have a thing where every half court shot they make look close.
No, I promise you there's air balls.
Oh, okay. Cause I'm fine with it.
Guys, what is this line going to be now? Because we got Michigan up by two, 5 minutes left in this game. They got to put Kamar Baldwin in the game. He's got to play the remainder of the game. If you think the Bulldogs have any chance of winning this game.
What is the score right now, Sean?
Michigan by two.
Yeah, it's 31-29, correct? That's what I have it. That's what my scorebook. I'm actually keeping, like those old guys who keep track of the score when you go to a baseball game. I'm one of those guys. Butler getting the ball to start the fourth quarter. We're closing it out strong here on DGen Madness. Of course, sportsgamblingpodcast.com. Subscribe, rate, review, and share on iTunes. Butler.
They got to get some more movement going. I hate this offense here. It's too stagnant.
Stagnant, stale, not exciting.
Watch the pick. Oh,
steal, open break, and we got a dunk.
Call that timeout. That's
the momentum swing you love to see coming out of a quarter. Total is up to 62 points. Michigan 33, Butler 29.
All right. Baldwin, it's got to be Baldwin mode here. They got to get him the rock.
Live line is now Michigan 2K CPU -1.5.
That's a bad foul. They have not taken a good shot in minutes, and you're going to bail them out with a foul.
That's not what you want to do if you're Michigan. You don't want to give them an option to get back in the game you're running your offense correctly. You're boxing them out on the board. You're getting fast break points as they're pointing out. It's really a dream scenario.
And one thing, I think Butler holds the advantage. They're a better free throw shooting team than Michigan.
The line is down to pick right now.
Wow.
With -120 juice on Michigan. Wow. I love that. Yeah. They're expecting Butler to make a late run here, but I'm already walking to the booth with my +3.5 Michigan and my under. I don't think they can come back from a 7.
Here
and a half
comes overtime.
Swing.
He's off on the side. Wow. Gotta make your free throws.
And it wouldn't be a DJ and Madness without some missed free throws impacting the spread and the total. Great look. I'm fine with that. A bit contested by Michigan behind the arc three pointer.
Not his best game, but they're still getting it done.
Decent look by David Julius. I'm fine with that.
Michael James on Facebook pointing out this is a classic Butler game. Very realistic.
And if you're wanting to get in on the live lines, you can go to mybookie.ag. Their feed is up to date. The latest feed.
It's not a good look though.
You gotta get Baldwin involved.
Baldwin has. Where is Baldwin gone? He's gone MIA since early in the game.
Simpson is outplaying him at this point. He's not.
Now, if you're LeVar Jordan, you got to think maybe you start fouling Xavier Simpson in the next minute or two here.
Well, right now this is almost a must make.
They really don't.
Good shot.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of options left for Butler.
There we go. There we go.
Create a good shot.
And a timeout by Michigan here. That's fine. Butler felt like maybe they were getting a little momentum. I'm fine with that jumper if I'm a Michigan fan or a Michigan backer, which I am temporarily, because it's a mid-range jumper. What you don't want to do is get them to the foul line, get them easy looks, get them back in this game. Michigan just needs to keep running their offense, keep getting points in the paint. Castleton needs to come back in the game. That guy was red hot. I don't know what they were doing.
Shout out to superfan Scott Mickelson over watching the Periscope feed. Just hammered the final to be odd. Awesome. That is the kind of move we expect from the D-gens during D-gen madness. You're not taking a side. You're not taking a total. Just give me the odd. Well, as you know, I have transitioned my bet every first half under to bet every game odd, baby.
We have one guy doing a two screen experience.
No way.
I don't. It's unclear. I think he has both games going. Oh no, he's got it. He's running back Gonzaga UCLA on a side.
That's a great game. That's a great game. I remember that one.
So shout out to Mary to Mariota, probably a Titans fan there.
3 minutes to go. 3 minutes to go. Michigan up by two.
Oh, a steal.
And now
there we go. Giving it to Baldwin. Oh,
Baldwin breakaway dunk to tie the game. 33-33 total sitting
at
66.
They got the Baldwin faces going in the crowd. Hinkle Fieldhouse is going nuts.
Sean's got the radio voice.
Much like Joe Buck, I'm looking to make my name here with a great call.
Listen, this is what we call multi-dimensional arousal. I'm sorry, we talked over Gus.
If I had if I was in a sports book, I'd be standing up clapping right now. Livers gets to the line.
Livers.
I pronounce it livers. Livers gets to the line. That's what you need. Slow the game down. Keep pounding inside. And
he's one of those guys who will get penetration.
These are huge free throws here.
A lot of pressure.
Now, Michigan might have been misseeded a little bit. Livers was injured for a decent part of the season. Ever since he's been in the lineup, the Wolverines have been playing much better basketball.
6 foot seven junior from Kalamazoo, Michigan, with a big shot here to extend Michigan's lead to 2 points.
Both good from the line.
Sinks it. Big time free throws.
Line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his stroke, it never wavers.
Colby also has a consistency with his stroke.
I do.
You won't hear Joe Buck say that.
Great bad look. Great defense.
Come on.
Michigan forcing it. Slow things down. Get a good look, Michigan.
Lots of room to stay under the total here, Sean.
Some great ball handling by Michigan. Looking to set up their offense.
Using
some good ball movement. Getting the screen up top. That's one of my strengths in rec league basketball, calling out screens. Right.
No way.
Oh, that was a horrible shot
possession.
Shot selection.
He has that type of range, but I'm not sure who'd agree with it.
Butler, 18 rebounds so far, but it does feel like Michigan controlling the glass.
There it is.
Get out of here. Great defense by Michigan, and they're on the fast break.
1:23 left in the game.
Gets it inside.
Good foul. It's a smart foul. Make the bigs make the free throws.
I think we need overtime, Colby.
I think so, buddy. Either that or we start. You got to think Jordan's got to start fouling Xavier Simpson.
Guys, could we have the dream scenario? Overtime for the first game of DJ Madness. Will there be a buzzer beater?
Brandon Johns Jr., sophomore from East Lansing, at the line, wiping his hands on the shorts. Never a good sign. It means he's nervous. And I know I am, even though I'm catching 3.5 points.
And honestly, kudos to the Trump campaign for being smart enough to advertise within a video game.
Very much so.
I'm going all in on
you think
Trump.
They
on an NBA video
you
game.
You think they only bought advertising?
Demographic, probably.
Think they only bought the advertising in Indiana or some of the other arenas?
We'll find out in the late game. Tipping off
approximately pretty conservative too.
7 p.m. West Coast time.
It's a big shot.
10
right
o'clock
here.
East. Big shot. Michigan up by 2. Free throw is up and good, extending the lead to 3 points. 1:22 left on the clock.
They got to get. Let's get movement going. Why is Baldwin with the ball right now? You got to run him off some screens. Okay, there we go.
We've got 108 left in the fourth quarter.
Oh, great
go up,
defense.
Go up. What
block and a contested shot.
Wow.
Great board by Michigan.
No heart.
Xavier Simpson taking it to the line.
Okay, it's a smart foul.
That could be the game.
He's like a 60%. He's like a 56% free throw shooter. It's a smart foul.
Xavier Simpson, 6 foot guard at Olema, Ohio, the senior. I like to see a veteran. I like to see an upperclassman at the line late when I'm holding the ticket.
Recently, Xavier Simpson crashed the athletic director's car into a tree.
Yeah, he was stoned, right?
Yeah, and they did not test for big free throw there. That's the senior stepping up, but they did not test his blood alcohol content level.
37 to 33. If you're holding an over ticket, you're gonna need overtime.
And again, and all this data over at sportsgamblingpodcast.com. But Butler had won 63% of the simulations. This is reality. This is March.
Oh, he hits both.
This is March basketball.
Xavier Simpson doesn't want to go home.
Michigan,
he wants to drive
38.
That car. More
Butler,
and more.
33. Butler calling a timeout. I know that maybe it's the smart thing to do a timeout there, but I would have just let Butler run it down. And they needed a quick score. Maybe that's what they're looking to draw. A play coming out of the timeout.
Coach Kev, 24-24, pointing out he's now scared about the under for the late game. Perhaps he's going with the logic that if one game goes under, one game will go over.
Solid logic there, Ryan. I'm seeing the live line over at mybookie.ag right now, even.
No
juice either way. Michigan 2K CPU,
wow.
Butler 2K CPU.
A lot of faith in Kamar Baldwin.
A lot of faith that Butler is going to pull this out late, but I'm already considering, Ryan. Listen. Can we double or nothing? Our original bet, assuming I cash this, can we roll this over into UNC plus 10.5?
Well, you know, Sean, we're supposed to be impartial bystanders calling the game for the fans out there and enunciating as best we can. But I say we double or nothing. Why not?
I'm down.
Get Livers the ball.
I mean, here's the thing. I want action on these games.
Yeah.
So we're both good. If anyone wants to bet me, I'm in.
shots have come
there we go. Okay, we get he gets it in. Going straight. Okay. Oh. Smart. That, see, that's why you call a timeout. You only take a second and a half Baldwin, off the clock.
Baldwin made the right play. He took it to the line. Or sorry, took it to the hole. Got to the line. Doesn't take a lot of time off the clock. Gets them a chance to whittle away at this lead.
You got to think that if they keep fouling Xavier Simpson just off of the percentages, he's going to miss some of these.
And just to point this out, a couple other millions of simulations were run. The lowest scoring game was 64. So we are absolutely seeing an outlying game here. Sean, I just can't help but think this game is going to be going to overtime.
Because, like we said, I already took my winning. And rolled it over.
We're already doing double or nothing.
Yeah, we're already doing double or nothing.
That's also good. So all right, they got to play D now. They
Butler whittles the lead down to three. Butler 35, Michigan 38. Total sitting at 73. Not in play unless overtime becomes a factor, which it could here.
They're just going to play defense. They're not going to foul. Interesting, right. Interesting coaching philosophy from Jordan.
Oh no!
What onions?
Rebound!
Shot.
Rebound!
Onions Baldwin's shot by ball. Michigan. Baldwin has the ball.
Oh,
they're down three.
Give it up! Oh, golden oh. Two in the dunk!
Mama, there goes that man. Golden for
Bryce
the slam
golden.
Dunk. And now they foul. Interesting choice here.
I like it. I like it. Michigan, not a good free throw shooting team.
They're putting the team on the road.
Yes.
In a pressure situation. Look at him. He's not ready for this moment. He's wearing an arm sleeve because he doesn't trust his own jump shot.
Isaiah Livers, Kalamazoo, Michigan man, 6'7"
He's
junior.
So nervous.
Kalamazoo, the hometown of Derek Jeter.
Miss it.
First three throws up, and it's good.
Ice in his veins.
Onions.
Feel a little relief. 39-37, Michigan, 76 is the total. Even is the point total if you're betting that like a maniac.
Oh,
he hits two huge free throws.
What did you put the free throws at? They've hit six in a row.
Default value, baby.
Butler timeout. If you're Butler here, what do you do? Do you go for the 3-point shot coming out with 21? Do you work the clock?
Quick two, foul, two. All the percentages, like they've made six in a row.
Yeah.
I don't see that continuing.
And Butler Bulldogs, again, shout out to Barking Dogs hooking us up with the $3,000 prize package, which if you got your bracket in time, sportsgamblingpodcast.com/contest. Hopefully you got your bracket in. You're one of the hundreds and thousands of people who submitted one because it's free cash and it's free to enter. And of course, live lines over at mybookie.ag. My bookie may be ahead of the curve, maybe was onto something, realizing making that live line at even. I didn't see that coming, but
they know something.
I'll say this: if Kamar Baldwin gets a good look, shoot the three. If not, go for the quick two. Run your best set.
The live line looks like it's off right now, including odd and even point bet.
Here we go. The inbounds here.
Butler,
nice
looking
screen.
To get a
Baldwin's
quick score.
Open. What is he doing? Hold he throws on. It
gonna,
to him
I'm
late.
Gonna, I'm going to turn up the volume of the audio.
They're gonna set up for a late three. It feels like. Nope, he's taking it in.
Oh, gives it up.
Oh, good.
Take it to a goaltending. That's a goaltend.
And that is a late call. Late call by the computer.
No, I think I think they fouled. Yeah, they fouled.
That was a goaltend.
Oh, all right.
That was a goaltend.
Wow.
I thought they called the foul on
Butler's gonna go out like that.
Robbie Higby the third says Kramer FML tour update. He goes down in the Bites bracket final four and not looking good for
Xavier Simpson. There it is.
In D-Gen Madness, Xavier Simpson with a key free throw here to extend it to 4 points.
You're not
an insurmountable lead with only 8.4 on the clock.
Oh, he misses it. Get Bob with the ball. Get Bob with the ball.
Clear the board. Butler has a chance to tie this game.
McDermott. Sean McDermott!
Oh my God, are you kidding me? This is brutal.
This is the greatest thing ever. High five, let's go.
March is here,
baby. I'm a little drunk.
March is here. We're not supposed to be touching hands.
Virtual high five. Oh my God.
Do you believe in miracles? Michigan is tied with Butler at 40.
Who has that over?
The over. I already walked to the booth and cashed my Michigan +3.5 and my under. Oh,
Sean, we talked about this on the preview podcast last night. Will there be a buzzer beater made in the whole first round? And granted, this is just the tie of the game, yeah, but are you serious?
Still a buzzer beater in my book.
This counts as a buzzer beater.
I've watched, at this point, probably over 100 of these.
Yeah.
I've yet to see that happen.
Hey.
We got a request for the Gusgasm.
Now you gotta say this. I've been mentioning all game Xavier Simpson at the free throw line. He hit it too earlier, but now with the game on the line, he misses both. Here's right, Michigan
let's
ball up the NBA rules to advance the ball.
Oh!
That's one rule we forgot about, the advancing of the basketball.
That was a good look there. I feel good with that shot. The first ever D-Gen Madden is going into overtime. Are you kidding me?
Like, you gotta love it.
0.8 was enough for a catch and shoot. Not enough to get off a shot to go in. Everyone, all the Michigan backers, so pissed.
We are, I mean,
Sean McDermott, you know, he doesn't want his career to end. He's a senior. He's from Anderson, Indiana, straight up the road.
3 minute OT, still time to hedge over at mybookie.ag. Live line, Michigan at pick, as well as Butler, obviously there.
I mean, you got to think the momentum is now in Butler's favor.
Well, they're at home. They just hit a buzzer beater to tie the game.
There's a foul getting the big men in foul trouble.
And I'm fine with that foul. It's a contested basket right underneath the bucket.
Look pretty clean.
That looked pretty clean. I don't know what the computer is seeing on that one.
Wow. Hold on again. Everyone just take a breath.
March Madness, essentially. Hashtag DGen Madness. Ryan Daw checking in on the YouTube stream. Now if Butler outscores Michigan 4-0, I can hit all my bets.
Sean, I gotta tell you, I mean, Colby can kind of see it, but the chat. For all the, it's going too fast. I can't even read and react.
Lighting up like it's Ebbets Field.
It's a Christmas tree with these notifications. And why not? This is exciting basketball.
God bless America.
God bless America, USA. And of course, everyone for tuning in, spreading the word. Hashtag DGen Madness. Second shot here.
Oh no. Cousin Moose checking in. Had the under.
Oh no. In perfect DJ Madness fashion, Cousin Mush missing out, and maybe the under is still in play. These teams could get cold. Things could get interesting. Oh. Great move to the hole. He's double teamed now. Find the open man.
Oh,
using the glass.
It's a strong move.
Two people.
Strong move.
And Livers has come up late for Michigan, hitting free throws. Nice bucket off the glass. Michigan extending the lead, 42-40. Big Dog, of course, is on Butler number three.
Ball went for three.
Oh, good look. And we got a foul.
Oh,
on Butler on the rebound.
Wow.
I don't know about that. Can we get a replay on that?
Interesting foul call there. And where's Castleton been? That guy was red hot in the third quarter. Haven't seen him involved in offense for Michigan. Would love to see him back.
Oh man.
Wow. Great drive to the hole. Poor Xavier Simpson couldn't put it in. No one to blame but himself. The Butler.
There we go. Baldwin. Oh, okay.
Setting up the offense, getting it to Baldwin. Michigan covering him far out.
Get it. Look.
Gotta go.
Guys, it's at three. It's at two. It's at one. Somebody tell this guy.
Horrible.
Offensive board. Up. Oh.
Wow. That was a horrible possession. Almost bailed out with the offensive rebound, but no. Michigan gets the ball back. They're up 2 points. 42-40. Looking to run some clock here, but hopefully still get a good look. They're only up 2 points. Great drive into the paint. Nice look for the baby Jay.
You know,
it is double overtime in play. What do we got for the numbers?
They had Aaron Thompson on one of the bigs. It was a bad play there.
One more shot goes in and the over is hit. 84.5 was the total over at mybookie.ag. Now we're seeing the live line is pick for Michigan, but you're laying some juice at minus 170. Butler plus 130. Now we saw Butler come back in the fourth quarter. Kramer, would you rebuy Butler at plus 130 live right here?
I mean, I think when you look at a matchup, a minute 12 seconds left down four.
With
you
a bad, Michigan's a bad free throw
shooting
team.
You have Kamar Baldwin. Let Kamar Baldwin be Kamar Baldwin. Let him lead you back to the promised land. I think we're going to see the unbelievable double overtime. The 7 o'clock game will not tip as scheduled.
We're already pushing the 7 o'clock line. So, and of course, if you're tuning in, this feed ends. So we're going to retweet out the feed. Yeah. If you're on youtube.com sports gambling podcast, you'll see another live stream start to get the next game going. But of course, overtime, we got to say,
here we go.
Let's go.
Baldwin, stop. He's taking a lot of clock here. Make a move. Okay.
That's okay, his nice jumper.
Foul. A foul.
Wow. And that could have been the game right there. Great look in the paint. Xavier Simpson has the ball for Michigan.
Has Butler even scored in the overtime? They've missed two free throws and 0 for 3.
Wide open three. Drains it. And that could be the game.
Dagger.
The over just hit. So my under is screwed. But I'll take this Michigan +3.5. Baldwin to the rack,
it's done.
Rejected, and now it just feels like a formality. Michigan running the clock, moving on.
Wow,
just a 9-0 run in the last 2 minutes.
In the overtime period, 9-0 run.
Their defense came to play in overtime.
You got to
shutting out.
Taking too much time right here.
Right
now, they're not even trying. They're not even trying.
Contested three. They're not going to foul. And he can just dribble it out. Michigan looking like they're about to move on. The winners of the first game ever in hashtag DGen Madness. Congratulations to overbetters. Congratulations to folks like myself.
Odd cashes.
Odd was the play. Michigan +3.5 was the play. And the Butler tease, if you tease Butler, unfortunately, that did not play pay. Or if you had Butler laying 3.5.
So what time should we say? 15 minutes in between? 10 minutes in between?
I think 10 minutes. I think people are glued in right now.
All right. 7-11 tip time.
7-11 is the tip time.
Great game. Signing off here from the Hinkey Fieldhouse in beautiful
Indianapolis,
Indiana. Sad day for our Butler Bulldogs, Dantabase.
Yeah. And Michigan Big Blue moves on late game, looking to tip at 7-11. Kramer, anything else we have to do on this broadcast for this game?
Oh yeah, I have to. Yeah, I don't know how do I guess I'm supposed to show. I don't know. There's nothing here to show. I didn't mess with anything. You saw the game. I don't even know how to mess. Here are the stats. Yeah, we'll show the stats. This might be good for a grab tomorrow, Sean.
Yeah, great game.
Oh, I had a great time.
This was awesome. And of course, stay tuned. We'll be tipping the late game here. So yeah, stay tuned to the feeds. And of course, head over to mybookie.ag where you can, of course, use that promo code SGP. Play, win, and get paid. Deposit bonus up to $1,000. UNC +10.5. Gonzaga -10.5. Total sitting at 85.5. And we'll be right back for the late game in hashtag DGen Madness.